Next up, we have a lovely performance from Isla in year 8.
Next, we have Izzy singing Naughty from Matilda the Musical.
Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. So they say the subsequent fall was inevitable. They never stood a chance, they were written that way. Innocent victims of their story. Like Romeo and Juliet. Was written in the stars before they even met. That love tiny revolt, the seed of a war in the creak of a floorboard. A storm can begin with a flap of a wing, the tiniest might pack the mightiest sting. Every day start with the tip of a club, what escapes, start with the click of a lock. You're stuck in your story, and once you get out, you don't have to cry, you don't have to shout, cause if you let all you can do, hurt a lot of you. Must let a little thing like this to stop you. If you sit around and let them get on top of you, won't change a thing. Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay.
Next is a tap dancer. We have Anya from Year 8.
Next up with her musically performance act is Eddie Rose Bell in Year 10 from Monmouth Comprehensive School.
I stick with real things, usually facts and figures. When information's in its place, I minimize the guessing game. Guess what?
What?
I don't like guessing games or when I feel things before I know the feeling. How am I supposed to operate if I'm just tossed around by fate? Like, on an unexpected date? With a stranger who might talk too fast or ask me questions about myself before I've decided that he can ask me questions about myself. He might sit too close or call the waiter by his first name or eat Oreos but eat the cookie before the cream. But what scares me the most? What scares me the most is what if when he sees me, what if he doesn't like it? What if he runs the other way and I can hide from it? What happens then if when he sees me, he's only disappointed? What if I give myself away to only get it given back? I couldn't live with that. So I'm just fine inside my shell, shape mine. This way I get the best view, so that when he sees me, I want him to.
Don't you think you're being a little, baby, just...
I'm not defensive! I'm simply being cautious. I can't risk reckless dating due to my miscalculating why. A certain suitor stands in line. I've seen movies, most made for television. You cannot be too careful when it comes to sharing your life. I could end up a miserable life. I'm sorry, girls, but he could be criminal. Some sort of psychopath who escaped from an institution somewhere where they don't have girls. He could have masterminded some way to find me. He could be colorblind. How untrustworthy is that? He could be less than kind. Or even worse, he could be very nice, have lovely eyes, and make me laugh. Come out of hiding. What would I do with that? Oh God, what if when he sees me, I like him and he knows it? What if he opens up a door and I can't close it? What happens then? If when he sees me, my heart is set in motion, I'm not prepared for that, I'm scared of breaking open. But still I can't help from hoping to find someone to talk to who likes the way I am. Someone who when he sees me wants to again.